All right, I think we have everything together. Hello, everyone. How's it going? What's up? We are live, baby. We live. Listen, I'm trying so hard to try to bring you these every Thursday. But listen, the shit happens, okay? So welcome to The Mafia Speaks Live, okay? I've been doing these typically in a standard video, but I realized these would probably do way better in a live session. And now, if you're new here, essentially, The Mafia Speaks is a session where essentially you guys send in your stories and me and The Mafia chime in and give you advice. Now, for the most part, we try to be as objective as possible, but I'm gonna just tell you this right now, right? If you've watched my videos before, you would know I'm a very no-nonsense type of person. I do not sugarcoat. I do not give BS advice. I do not, like, beat around the bush. I can be kind of sensitive when it comes to certain topics, but for the most part, I don't give a fuck if you my mama, my best friend, my cousin. Anybody who knows me who's watching this right now can probably chime in right now. I don't give a fuck who you are. I'm going to tell you what it is that you need to hear because I'm that type of friend, okay? And without me, okay, without assholes like me, a lot of y'all would be making very horrible decisions, okay? If a lot of people have people like me in their life, they would do a lot less stupid shit. So with that being said, I'm really, really coming from a place of love with whatever I say, okay? Now, I know you guys see this damn title. And you guys are like, boy, what the fuck? Listen, I said the same thing. Now, also to preface, I do not read any of these, really. I just read the title or I'll read like the first part. I just get a little gist and I kind of throw about 2 to 3 together that kind of go together. And then, you know, I'll read them. Now, we're going to get straight into this and I'm going to try my hardest to kind of look at the comments. But if you guys are not aware, again, I have a little ADD going on, bipolar, all this other stuff. So it's hard for me to look at the comments and read and look at me. So I'm going to try to get through the stories first, see what you guys are saying, and then give my opinions. So like I said, these are emails. If you guys would like to send in your stories, please keep in mind that you should never send it to my The Mademoiselle Gmail. It is themafiaspeaks@gmail.com. It is linked down below in the description box. It will later be pinned, but do not send it to my professional email. I will automatically delete that shit. Like, do not, okay? So thank you guys so much for all the kind comments. I see them. Thank you so much. Get your tea, get your snacks. I have grapes. Okay, I have my grapes and I have my water. I would have wine, but I might have to drive after this because apparently the Mademoiselle has to save the day today. I got a lot of things on call, so I might have to maybe make this quick. Who knows? Who knows? So let us see. Let us see. You know, it'd be so sad if I like accidentally lost the story because I don't see it. And see it, y'all. I don't got time for this, y'all. Where the fuck is the stories? Oh, my God. I do not have time for this. You know what, y'all? I'm just going to give up. I give up, y'all. I give up. One day, y'all going to come to YouTube, and my entire channel is going to be deleted. Like, I'm going to get a 9-to-5, change my name to, like, Genevieve La Quantes. Like, come on. I guess I probably, like, I have no idea where this would be at, but I'm trying to find it, y'all. I'm going to find it because there's no way I deleted it. That makes no sense. No sense. So we're trying. We're trying. We're trying to find it, y'all. Any day now. Like, this is... But, I feel like there was something else I had to tell you guys. I completely forgot. Oh, keep in mind, my next live is not scheduled yet. It's going to be on Haitians and Dominicans because there's lots of conversations going there. It's going to be with Christina. She's amazing if you guys do not watch her content. And yeah, you guys need to make sure you guys watch that, tune into that. It's going to be scheduled sometime this week. And honestly, Jesus Christ, where did I put it? Y'all, I'm really trying to find a story. I really, like, deleted them or something. Hold up, hold up. why would I there's no way I deleted this story. Oh, found it. I put it under something else, y'all. I'm slow. All right, so let's read this. I'm going to try to get through this right now. All right, so. Woo, chow, chow, chow. I really just needed to get this off my chest. So, I'm 16 and I have 11 sexual partners already. And not one of these men have I been in a relationship with. Honestly, I really don't even enjoy sex that much. I lost my virginity when I was 13 to an older boy. He was 16, maybe 17. He was my friend's brother. I didn't have sex again after that until I was 14. And I started meeting new groups of people and attracting more boys that were way too old for me. I'm gonna have to pause right there. What kind of brother do you have? I have no brothers, right? But I have a lot of boys in my life that have seen me as a little sister. I'll be damned if they ever let me near any of their friends. Because there have been times I've tried and they're like, don't you ever, right? So I would assume if I had a biological brother, they would never let me anywhere near their friends. So that's one. Second of all, yikes. Where's your parents? This is extremely unfortunate. I'm just sitting here like, yikes. I mean, I lost my virginity pretty young too. I believe I was like 15 or 16. That's still pretty young, but 13 is like, yikes. Why is a 16-year-old having sex with a 13-year-old? I mean, all of it is young, but I'm assuming like a 16-year-old would be having sex with another 16, 17, maybe even 18-year-old, not a 13-year-old. I'm seeing an exploitation in power struggle here, but okay. Okay. I never lied about my age, and I now understand that most of the men I've been I've been sexually active with took advantage of me. Oh, I'm so happy you know that. They definitely did. Even though I consented to each and every one of them, I felt pressured so many times, but I still feel like that's not an excuse. Anyway, now that I'm a little older and I've calmed down and learned my worth, I feel so ashamed of myself because I allowed all of these men to take advantage of me. I never had an STD. Thank God. Yeah, thank God. Thank God. I never had sex with more than one person at a time, and a lot of the things I've done, I did because I wanted some love. I always had pure intentions. I just thought they wouldn't like me if I didn't let them, and I know now that that's a stupid way of thinking, and I know it's something deep-rooted. I know I must have some mental problems, but I can't figure out why. My childhood wasn't the best, but it wasn't bad. My dad was in and out of prison. That's all you had to say. Your dad was in and out of prison. What do you mean it was that bad? All right. Girl. Your dad's in and out of prison. That's problem number a million. My dad was in and out of prison almost all my life. He's been out for a couple of years now, and I realize I have amazing parents. I live in a really small city, and I just... No, everybody thinks of me as a disgusting or nasty, but sometimes I want to sit and cry because I know I've ruined myself. I know I'll never be worth enough for a relationship, at least not in the city. I don't really have a question. I just had to tell somebody or it would have eaten me up inside. All right, let me just tell y'all this right now, right? I know a lot of girls like this that I grew up with, especially in high school. Deadass. A lot of them was just out here fucking and sucking every and everything. I literally knew girls that had their first kid at 12, 13. I kid you not. And a lot of them stayed like this. A lot of them, it was a phase. A lot of them maintained the fact that, you know, they just like fucking and sucking. Like, it is what it is, right? But for the most part, the whole teenage promiscuity situation is a legitimate issue. I like the fact that she's very well aware that she may have an issue. I honestly don't think this girl has much of an issue. I feel like she most likely was vying for attention, like she said. I feel like she most likely was just going through a phase. I don't feel like she's a hell person. I don't even want to say that. I really feel like it could have just been a phase. I feel like it could have just been one of those situations where, like, she was just easily manipulated and... That's that. Shit does happen.
It is what it is. Having 11 bodies at 16 is insane. It really is a lot. And I'm not going to say all of it is entirely her fault, because most likely a lot of those boys took ridiculous advantage of the girl. But to be quite honest with you, like, all of those girls that I've known that have been in that type of position have been going through ridiculous home issues. Okay, I'm talking about daddy issues. I'm talking about mommy issues. I'm talking about dog issues. Like, issues. Like, I don't know not one promiscuous teenager that I grew up with, and I'm not even talking about just girls, right? Because I feel like a lot of people like to demonize females. Okay, apparently girls are the only ones that could be promiscuous. Apparently girls are the only ones that could thot around and all of that extra shit. I'm telling you this right now. Boys can be promiscuous as well, and boys are just as susceptible as being called disgusting and being horrible in terms of, you know, that realm, okay? So we're not just going to put it all on women, all on girls, all on, you know, being raised by a single mother, because, of course, not having a father has a lot to do with it. And, of course, boys being hoes is not okay. I don't give a fuck. It's not okay. No, it is not different, okay? You sticking your peen in any and everything that walks is just as bad as a girl letting any and anything enter her. I said what the hell I said. So regardless of the fact, the whole teenage promiscuity situation is a very serious issue, because even though a lot of people like to push this whole culture of do what you want, there's a lot of consequences for doing what you want. Everyone wants to sit here and say it's okay to fucking suck any and everything, but y'all need to understand, when you're telling people it's okay to fucking suck everything, you're also telling kids that it's okay to fucking suck everything. When you're sitting here telling people, oh yeah, live your best life, YOLO, whatever the fuck it is that y'all say these days, hot girl summer, hot girl winter, summer, spring, fall, whatever the hell, that is a very dangerous rhetoric. Because at the end of the day, these young kids do not know what the consequences of their actions are. Sis talking about she know that people don't really, you know, respect her in her city. She knows that she's not gonna be held at a higher regard, and she's right. So sis, if you're watching this, move, just leave. They never gonna respect you. I kid you not. I'm 26, and there's people that I kid you not, I know was promiscuous when we was like 13, 14. I'm 26 now. They be like, hey, yo, you remember Jennifer? What the hoe? Oh my God, you remember Sean? Yeah, the nigga that was fucking everybody. Oh, yo, you remember yeah, the hoe. It never dies. Trust me. If you was known as the hoe, no matter who you end up with, most likely in the neighborhood, you're going to be known as the hoe. Don't matter if you become the new modern day Teresa. It don't matter if you become a nun. You're still going to be known as the neighborhood thot. I suggest you move. I'm just telling you this right now. I'm telling you how it is. I suggest you move. I suggest you legitimately just start over somewhere else. Because at the end of the day, like, why would you even want to be there anyway? Especially with all of these men that boys that manipulated the hell out of you in the first place. Also, why would you even blame yourself for this? Like, I can't even blame you for this, honestly. Like, for most cases, sometimes I just be sitting there like, nigga, you put yourself in this. But this, I can't blame you. Don't blame yourself for this. Just don't. I really can't blame this girl for this. Like, you're a kid. These boys are sitting here manipulating the hell out of you. I just want to know where your mom is. You said your dad is in and out of jail. So we know what, you know what deadbeats do. We know the statistics there. Where's your mom? I don't understand. Did I miss a part? Did I, like, not read the mom part? Like, I don't, y'all need to watch y'all fucking kids, bro. Y'all really do. And I don't understand, why is it? And I know if there's some parents watching this, they're going to be so upset. Because every single time I tell people to watch their kids, they want to catch an attitude. Every single time I tell someone, watch their kids, oh, you don't have no kids, you can't say that. Shut the fuck up. Yes, the fuck I can, you bitch. Okay? Because to be honest, if my parents was watching me, I wouldn't be the way the fuck I was. Listen, I love my parents. They done a lot of shit that I'm like, bruh, like, you shouldn't have done that. You should have been doing a lot better in terms of, like, being more financial responsible, so I didn't have to be homeless and live with my best friend's family. If I didn't live with my best friend's family, I would have never lost my virginity. I lost my virginity because I was legitimately not at home. You know, so realistically, if I was at home, I probably would have never lost my virginity. You know, so it's just like little shit like that. It's like, come on now. Watch your goddamn fucking kids. Make better decisions, right? I understand. We do the best we can. I get it. I love my parents to death, okay? I do. I really do. But at the same time, it's one of those things where it's like, a little common sense goes a long way. Ooh, a little common sense goes a long way. Everyone wants to just throw a tablet, throw a phone, and throw all these extra shit at their kids. Nobody wants to talk to their kids. Nobody wants to take their kids nowhere. No one wants to ask their kids how their day is. No one wants to do anything. No one. But everything is everyone else's fault. Understand that when you sit in here and you give your kids phones, you give your kids all this freedom, all of this free range to do whatever they want, they're going to be exposed to shit. They're going to be exposed to different people, different environments, different ideologies that you did not instill within them. You can sit there and be like, oh, I raised you better than that. I taught you to do this, that. It don't fucking matter what you raise your kids to do, not do, whatever. I'm a full-grown adult and I don't go down my timeline because I'm mortified by the shit that I see on my timeline. If it's not a black man being killed by the cops, it's a porn video. If it's not a porn video, it's a kid being abused. If it's not a kid being abused, it's some other shit that I did not sign up for. And me being 26, it's hard to believe that there can literally be like a 12-year-old or even a 7-year-old seeing the same shit that I'm seeing. If that's not enough for you to not be letting your kid have unsupervised access to the internet, I don't know what is. But no. Y'all want to sit there and be like, oh, I'm busy, I'm tired, you don't know what it's like. I don't give a fuck. Y'all can say that all y'all want, but when your kid end up not knowing their timetables, when your kid end up missing, and I see you crying on CNN, when your kid end up fucking and sucking everybody on the block, when your kid end up going to meet somebody in Minnesota that they met on Discord, on Instagram, or whatever the case may be, I don't want to hear it. Because you put that environment in their hands. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. I won't shed a tear. I won't post that shit on my page. Don't be sending me no, oh, my child's missing. Nope. Because you gave your kid access to unsupervised measures. Therefore, I don't feel bad for you. So, I'm going to look at this stuff. I'm looking at the comments. Oh my God, thank you guys for all the amazing comments. Yep, I said Discord, y'all. Listen, y'all, Discord is crazy as hell, y'all. Discord be having a lot of crazy stories. Y'all ever go on YouTube and watch Discord stories? There's some crazy stories. There be people out here making suicide pacts. Freaking parents come home, they kids hanging themselves in closets. Like, this shit real serious. Y'all think this is a game. This is not a game. Like, my kids not touching internet unsupervised till they're like 16. Like, I'm dead serious. Like, this shit is scary, bro. This shit is not a game. No. Mm-mm. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Mm-mm. Anyways. I do have a Discord, though, y'all. I do have a Discord. Join the D-Mafia Discord. Just don't talk to the creepy people. I don't even answer friend requests on there. I literally go in there, talk to D-Mafia, hop right on, hop off. I don't have time for this shit. Hey, mm-mm, creepy people. Mm-mm. Mm. All right. Next one. Oh my God. There's so many messages. Thank you guys so much for all the kind comments. Oh my God. Thank you so much. All right. So let's get into the next one. Now, honestly, this was supposed to be the title of the video, but to be quite honest with you, the other one was actually way more important to talk about. The whole teenage promiscuity situation. So let me just close out that, right? In terms of your teen being promiscuous, if your kid is being promiscuous, most likely it's because they feel like there's something they're not obtaining. They feel like they're not getting enough attention. They feel like they're not being heard. They feel like they're not getting enough love in their household. Whether it's from the man, whether it's from their father, their mother, something. They feel neglected. Either you work too much, the father works too much. It's something in terms of not getting enough attention. If you're not giving your kid enough attention, they're going to seek it in sex. Okay? That's what it is. Boy, girl, dog, cat, whatever. They're going to seek it in another person to fulfill that. So most of the time, that's what it is. Or they can literally have a sex addiction, which, you know, yeah. But at that point, they would have to go to therapy. That's a whole nother situation. I do have a couple friends that do have a sex addiction. That's a whole nother problem. But usually that does kind of come from that tube that usually ends up being something that turns into something very, very serious. But for the most part, in teens, that's where it starts. You kind of want to tackle that first. So, yes. All right. So, next one. Whew. This was supposed to be the title, but let's see. I have been with my fiance for 7 years. He wouldn't leave the streets alone and is now incarcerated for 6 to 10 years. Do I even have to read the rest of this shit? There's some people that I swear to God that be sending me these D-Mafia speak shits that I just be wanting to like just delete my whole existence. If this girl, if I read this entire thing and she's sitting here talking about some shit, I still wait for this nigga while he's still in jail. I might just pull one of my braids out. I might. They got it short. He is a very respectful person, a good father, and all-around person. Unless this is going to be followed with he didn't do it, I don't give a fuck. Why is he incarcerated for 6 to 10 years? He's a respectful person, a good father, an all-around good person. Why is he in jail for 6 to 10 years? You know what? Maybe it's a... Why would you be... I'm trying. What's something that you could be... Fraud. Maybe he's in jail for... Nope. That's scamming people. That doesn't make you a good person now, does it? I know I'm not the only one with this issue. I'm currently in college and working towards my career, and we are sticking together through this. That is so... stupid. That is so... I'm gonna talk to you like one of my friends for real. Because I've had friends that's done this stupid shit. And to be honest with you, we're not friends anymore. Because that makes no fucking sense. Especially if you have kids with him. Are you dumb or are you stupid? When you sit there and you have kids with degenerate lowlives like this, you know what you do? You let your kids know that it's okay to be with and exhibit this type of behavior. I don't give a fuck. You're in school doing shit for yourself, putting your life on hold with kids for a fucking nigga that's in jail for 6 to 10. You think if you went to jail, for 6 to 10 years, he would wait for you? Better yet, he's respectful. He's a good father. He's a good father from jail? He does piggyback rides in jail. He gets the kids formula from jail on his little 2-cent salary. I'm confused. I want to know how to be a father or a mother from jail. I need some pointers. Because I heard jail life is pretty cool. You know, you got to pay rent. Free insurance. I need to understand this logic right here, bro. I didn't even finish reading this shit, and I know I'm getting amped. I'm confused. Y'all need to stop this shit right now, bro. Cause sometimes I just be like, okay, are y'all really just asking because you really want to know, or you need somebody to yell at you, or do you like just really want to? Nah, dead ass, bro. Dead ass. We dead ass right now. How is somebody a good father from jail? Because I'm confused. I'm not confused. I'm confused. I'm confused. Oh, my God. And I need to get my laptop charger before this shit die. Hold on, my friends. Hold on.
I'm always doing shit. I always forget something, bro.
There you go. I need to understand. I need someone to help me understand legitimately. How is someone a good father from jail? Comment down below, guys. I need y'all to comment in the live chat. I need y'all to comment down below. I want to know. What can I do from jail to be a good parent? Because it doesn't add up. That shit just made me mad. All right. Let's read the rest because it's short. And I hope she's not about to ask. Okay. I'm currently in college and working towards my career, and we're sticking through this together. We read that. However, I get so lonely, frustrated, and depressed, and so does he. I don't give a fuck. Was you lonely and depressed when you was committing your crime, sir? Were you thinking about your kids when you was committing your crime, sir? Yo, everybody want to be lonely, depressed, and full of all of this crazy shit after they done did they crime. Listen, I don't have time for this. I don't feel bad for nobody that get locked up. I always tell my hood friends, okay, yeah, listen, I grew up in the hood. I love my hood friends so much, but I be telling them, if you get locked up, good bitch. I hope they keep you, bitch. You a menace to society, bitch. And honestly, I'd rather you be in jail than in a coffin. I'd rather that, because I'd rather go to a funeral. I'd rather not, my bad. I'd rather not go to a funeral than, you know, I'd rather not. I'd rather visit you in jail. Sorry. Keep your ass off the street. I don't got time. My taxes pay for that shit anyway. Like, I don't have time for this shit. Listen, you talk about something, oh, I'm lonely. You can leave his ass alone. He paying child support with his 2 cents he making in jail? What the fuck is this? Oh, my God. I do not have friends because I don't have time for the shenanigans. You don't have friends because you know damn well your friends is going to drag you the way I'm dragging you and the mafia is dragging you in this live chat right now. I'm peeping these comments and woo, child. You don't have friends because you don't have child for the shenanigans. Let's be real. You don't have time for the shenanigans. Come on now, listen. I'm going to tell you this right now. Okay? And for a lot of you guys who like want to say things in this comment right here, y'all probably gonna hate me, but be wary of any female who says they don't got no friends, because they're usually the fucking problem. Especially those girls that be like, I don't have female friends. Female friends are drama. Female friends are such issues. Thank you so much for the super chat. It says, I just want to say thank you for everything. Oh, thank you, Geneva. Oh my god, female friends, they're just so much problems. Those is the motherfuckers that you gotta watch out for, okay? The people that say they ain't got no friends, the people that says they ain't got no female friends, especially, those is the ones. Because if you're so, I don't have no female friends, I don't have no friends, bitch, that means you're the problem. What are you talking about? Are you not female? Do you not have a vagina, motherfucker? Who are you? That shit really annoys me. It makes no fucking sense. No fucking sense. You most likely don't have friends because you know your friends are going to call you out. They're going to tell you you're dumb. They're going to tell you, leave that man. Let's go to the club. Let's get a drink. Let's go shake our ass for a real nigga. Because that's what you need to be doing. You're in college. You need to be living your best life. Look at you. Thank you for the super chat. Look at you. Waiting on a nigga in jail. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. Unless you have a legitimate mental health issue in terms of you being very socially awkward or like really you have an issue for the most part. If you legitimately are a normal person, you're telling me you have no friends, most likely you're toxic. Or you don't like hearing other people's opinions. I'm an asshole. Y'all see me. Y'all, I'm an asshole. I got 5 solid best friends and I have a very good friend group. People invite me to shit all damn day and I decline. So if an asshole like me has friends, that's ridiculous. You telling me you don't got no friends. Bullshit. It's because you're toxic. Anyways, we're not even done. We're not done. Wow. He has one child whom is taken care of by the mother of his child. Wait, this is not even your kid? Y'all don't even have a kid. He has a whole nother kid. You are, hold up. So this is a nigga that you picked up that already had a kid that's not even your kid? Jesus Christ, girl, let it go. Let it go. Let it go. This is ridiculous. What? He has one child whom is taken care of by the mother of his child, family members, and myself. I need some advice. Why are you taking care of a kid that is not yours? Are you... Alright, you know what? I'm getting hot. This sweater's stressing me out. Why are y'all all taking care of this kid? No one told his bitch ass to go to jail. That's the mother fault. She wanted to go open her legs for a fuck nigga. Now the community wanna come raise the kid. I mean, that's cool and all, but... This has to be the most stupid shit. I don't understand. What do you want me to say? Now you're engaged. I want to know when this engagement happened. Did it happen when he was going to get locked up? Before he was locked up or while he was in jail? Because most likely, he's only keeping you there so you can send him commissary. If you guys are not aware, basically that's money or usually items sent to the person while they're in jail. If you have someone while you're out, or while you're inside, they basically send you money. And if you are married in jail, that person, sometimes depending on what jail, you know, you can have conjugal visits, which means you can have intercourse and stuff, whatever, in jail. So, my spidey senses are telling me he's only keeping you around for his own personal benefit while he's locked up until he can have someone to help him when he gets out. Meanwhile, you're sitting here suffering and putting your life on hold for some nigga that's probably not even worth a fucking 50 cents. Stop playing with me, bruh. You know damn well you should not have typed that shit. What did she expect me to write, y'all? What did she expect me to write? I don't... When y'all say certain things to me, for real, like, do y'all really expect it to be like, oh my God, sis, like, damn, like, I feel bad for y'all. No. You... put yourself in that situation and you got to get yourself out. You went to go stay engaged to a nigga that's going to jail for 6 to 10 years. Why the hell would you? That man would never. You know what? Better yet, guys, let me just tell you this right now. If a man were to wait for you, if I knew any man that would wait for you while you got locked up, this would be a whole different thing. But I don't know any man that would wait for a bitch at all. If she got locked up, except for Papoose, okay? That's a random occurrence, okay? Remy Ma got her a real one. But you don't see that shit. That shit is not regular. It's not a normal occurrence. Maybe if you guys were married. Just maybe. But to be quite honest with you, for the most part, any guy in a general sense is not going to put his life on hold for you. And for the most part, this man is very, 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 very selfish for sitting here and going to go run his illegal activities. I don't know what he did. And it's funny because she conveniently left out what he did. I really want to know what he did. I want a name. I want something. I want to look this nigga up because you guys, if y'all know, you could look up inmates. If you got the name, you could look up all they charges. Run it up, motherfucker. I want to know. Robbery, murder, fraud, prostitution. Like, I want to know what he did because... This doesn't make any sense. Did you not know what you were doing when you... Oh my God. I'm about to die. And no, I'm not wearing any makeup for those that are asking. All I have is lip gloss and I just got some lash extensions done. Oh my God. I'm about to die. Like, guys, this is ridiculous. To be honest, I just can't understand why people put themselves in these situations. Understand that you are better than this, y'all. Anybody in this situation that be watching this, please don't be waiting for nobody that's in jail. Waste of time. Please don't be sitting here getting with niggas and bitches with kids. Waste of time. If you don't already have a kid, right? If you have a kid already, it's fair game. But for the most part... If you're getting with people that have kids, you're going to end up being a parent. And I'm just telling you this right now for the people that's probably going to come out. Nah, yes, you are. When you date people with kids, eventually, unless you just, I don't know. For me, I would assume that when people date, they date for serious shit, right? Like, you date to eventually become married. And when you're married, essentially, if the person has a kid, you become a step-parent. If you, therefore, have had absolutely no kids, you're going to become a fucking parent. For a lot of people that have never had a kid, that's a very, very, like, big shock. That's a big step from being single to having a legitimate kid. So I would very, very highly suggest not to get in a relationship with someone who has a kid. It's not all shits and giggles. It's not just, oh, let me take a photo op and make the baby mother mad. Oh, let me just pull up and make the baby father upset. No, this is legit. Like, you're literally entering into a child's life. You're literally becoming a very prominent figure in this child's life. It's not just one of those situations where you're just, oh, pop in, pop out. Let me fuck the mom. Let me fuck the dad. No. Because eventually, if this shit gets serious, you're this person's step-parent. So when y'all sitting here thinking it's not serious to be dating people with kids, it is that serious. Especially if you're dating people that got crazy baby mothers and baby fathers that will pull up. Sorry, y'all, that's my dryer. If you sitting here, I hate that damn sound. That shit is so annoying. If you're sitting there thinking that this shit is shits and giggles, is not. I'm telling y'all. Like, it's all fun and games till that crazy baby mother or that crazy baby father pull up on you and they shoot you or they stab you or they rob your house or do whatever because they don't want you around their kid. This shit is not funny. It's really not funny. Like, and you guys may think it's extreme, but it's really not. Some people really don't play about their kids. Some people really aren't over their exes, especially the ones they have kids with. Some people really just don't play about their kids. You cannot just be out here willy-nilly having all of these types of relations with any and everybody with kids. You cannot just be willy-nilly throwing your life away for motherfuckers that be in jail. That's fucking selfish. Why the hell are you letting yourself get locked up when you got kids? What kind of shit? Listen. Jesus Christ. I can't. Thank you guys. Yeah, that dryer shit is so fucking annoying. I have the Samsung dryers, the smart dryers, and it's still drying. So I don't know why it's making noise. That shit. I have to call Samsung again. Anyway. Man, listen. People be thinking that just because they date somebody with a kid, they don't have to date the kid, nigga. You dating the kid, too. You dating the whole damn kid. I don't care. That's y'all business. Don't be mad when the baby mother, baby father run up on you. I ain't gonna say shit to y'all. Niggas don't be playing about their kids. I will never in my life date a nigga with a kid again. Last time I tried to date a nigga with a kid, short mini story time, y'all. One time, see, this is one thing, right? I'm the type of person, if I'm telling you not to do something or I'm giving you advice on something, it's because I've been through it. I'm not all these other little YouTubers, I ain't even gonna say no names, that be coming on YouTube trying to give y'all life advice on shit that they don't know about. I'm not gonna give you marriage advice because I ain't married. I ain't gonna give you credit advice because I just got rid of two of my collections today. I'm a real bitch. I ain't about to tell you or give you advice on shit that I don't know about. But for the most part, if I've been through it, I'm be like, listen. Or if I know or been close to people that have been through it, I'm be like, listen, don't do it. Let me tell y'all. I said one day, you know what? Let me stop. Maybe I'm single because I'm giving people, not giving people the benefit of the doubt. Y'all saw this dude. He was cute. Where did I meet him? I don't remember. Well, he was cute. You ever listen? You know how some dudes just be cute with a hat on? He was just cute with a hat on because the bullshit never stopped. So I met this dude. I have no idea where I met him. Like, I really can't remember where I met him. I feel like I met him somewhere. But whatever, we had a full-blown conversation. It was like a 5-6 hour conversation. Vibes were good. Conversations were good. He had a daughter. He's a single dad. The mother is allegedly a drug addict that moved from New Jersey to upstate New York to live her best girl, hot girl, winter, summer, spring, and fall. And basically, you know, he's just been toughing it out. I'm not going to give any more details because he might be on here or somebody might know him. To be honest, I don't give a fuck. What are you going to do? He's was a firefighter. Like, he had a nice little whatever. I was like, wow, that's so cute. You know, like, you're a single dad, you know. The mom's not in the picture. And I've always told people legitimate, for real. Like, if I was to date a nigga with a kid, it'd have to be a kid whose mom is nowhere around. Like, she's going to have to be dead or incarcerated. That may sound harsh, but, like, I'm not trying to deal with it. I don't want to deal with nobody's baby mother problems. I don't want no bitch coming to be like, oh my God, yeah, I'm a kid. I'm not an actress. I don't do scenes. I don't do shows. I don't do all of that rah-rah goofy bullshit, right? So essentially, me and the dude made up. And first of all, if you guys do not know, I'm a very, very, if you guys watch my story times before, most of my story times usually go south because motherfuckers be trying to test me by showing up late. This motherfucker came like 2 hours late. I think he was supposed to meet me up at like 4. He popped up at like 6. What? Whatever. And he didn't have his hat on. So I'm like, oh my God, like, you're not cute with a hat. So already I'm mad because you late and you're not cute without a hat. Like, he was not cute. So I'm already like, ooh. And every single time I was talking to him, he just kept bringing up, oh, you'd be a good role model for my daughter. You know, my daughter would really like you. And every time we'd be talking, he'd try to, like, put his daughter on FaceTime. And he'd be like, you know, what's your favorite color? My daughter's favorite color is... I mean, that's cute and all. You know, PBS Kids and shit, whatever. Baby Shark, do, whatever. But, like, I don't want to hear about that. You know, I want to hear about, like, not that. Like, I just, it was weird, okay? It was so weird. It was like every 2 seconds. Like, yeah, you know, it's just you'd be a great role model for my daughter, for me. People be really telling me this all the time, and it's like, yo, I curse like a sailor. And I understand cursing is, I guess, bad, but it's not like the worst thing. Like, you know how many times, thank you very much, Italiz, thank you. A lot of people will come up to me like, y'all, I'll be in the mall because, y'all, I'm from Jersey. I'll be in Elizabeth. I'll be in Jersey Gardens sometimes. People's, like, kids will come up to me with their parents, and their parents be like, oh, my God, my daughter watches you. And I'm like, don't y'all watch y'all fucking kids? I fucking curse like a sailor. Like, it's so weird. It's like, whatever. Like, whatever. If y'all want y'all kids to watch me, whatever. I find it so weird, right? I guess I'm decent. Yes, I went to school. I'm educated. I got a bachelor's. I got a master's. I'm self-employed. I got my life together. I got my shit together, which is very good for my age. I get it. But at the same time, it was just weird. It's like, I'm trying to get to know you. I don't want to say I don't care about your kid, but I don't want to hear about your kid this much. So fast forward, I was really annoyed and I was not happy that he was late. The date was very trash. He didn't have a car. And that was red flag number one. So he came late. He didn't look cute with the hat. He already had a kid. He didn't have a car. Wow, we're about to be on strike number motherfucking 5. So at this point, he's trying to get me to bring him home. And I'm like, I don't need no nigga in my passenger. What the fuck is this? No. Like, no. Like, how did you get here? He's like, oh, one of my boys dropped me off my car in the shop. And to this day, y'all, let me just say that I got this nigga on Facebook and I've never seen this car, and this car looks like it's forever in the shop, as in probably in the shop so damn much that it probably never fucking existed. Also, keep in mind that this is when I was single for real, and I must have just been down bad. This is at the time where I was just trying to give niggas chances because I felt like maybe I was just overlooking the good guys. But clearly, this is why I always tell people, don't just give niggas chances just because they seem nice on the outside. Because for the most part, all of these nice guys that I've given chances to have been horrible. From this nigga to the other nigga that I went on a date with that left me stranded in the hood, this other nigga that didn't have a toilet, These were the nicest guys that I've ever met that I thought were nice until I had to be one-on-one with them, right? And yes, the nigga without the toilet, I definitely have a story time about him. You guys can reference that. So essentially, everything was cool until one day we were on Facebook together. And I think he said something. I would comment on his stuff because, like, we're cool. We're friends, right? Like, you like me, I like you. And one day he posted something and I commented under it. And why the fuck his baby mother came talk about some, this bitch be commenting on your shit too much. I was like, don't you have a daughter to go raise? Or are you still avoiding responsibility? Because I don't understand why you're so worried about me when you don't even take care of your kid. Who the fuck? Ayo! I was done. I was like, see, this is why I don't date niggas with kids. Like, the bitch came at me hard body. I was like, she not about, like, oh my God. So me and her start going back and forth. And I'm like, you see, this is why. This is why I don't do niggas with kids. And I don't know who she thought she was talking to, but she got the right one, okay? She got the right one, and I had to send her to collections because she a bum bitch, okay? She a bum bitch, and she broke. So, yeah, she ain't mess with me ever again after that. Now all they do is talk shit about each other on Facebook all day, and I'll be telling him, like, listen, you lay down with her, lay off of it because you look stupid. Y'all both look stupid. But, yeah, I was done with him. I just talk about some, this bitch being your fucking mentions too much. Like, come on now. I can't. Like, it's too much. Like, these girls be doing too much. Unnecessary drama. Like, go spend time with your daughter. Does your daughter even remember who you are? Does she even remember your face? Does your daughter know your name? Does your daughter know she has a mom? But no, you so worried about talking to me. This is why I can't. I know. No, they're going to kill me. They're going to kill me. They're going to kill me. I'm going to get killed. Like, that's it. They're going to kill me. Like, I wouldn't be able to do it. Like, I'm not that type of bitch. Like, I'm not going to shut up. Like, that's it. I don't give a fuck. Like, so, nah. So, basically, yeah, me and that guy aren't friends anymore because I had to tell him about himself. I was like, you're really annoying. Like, all you do is talk shit about your baby mother all day. And if it's not about that, it's about your daughter, which your daughter's precious and all. But it's like, I don't want to hear about your baby mother. I don't want to hear about all of these issues. It was just too much. So let's go on to the final story. So, child, this final story I actually didn't look at whatsoever. I mean, I don't really read these, but I kind of read like a little bit. Oh, shit, this one's kind of long. So we're kind of going back to a little bit younger, but older. I guess it's like a flashback because I'm reading some of it right now. So next one. Longtime high school lover, Sean. Ooh, we try not to do names, but I already read it. But I hope that this person isn't watching this because I've had some beef here where motherfuckers had like tried to like be like, oh my God, I watched this story this person sent in about me. Yeah, didn't go well. So let's see. Longtime high school lover, Sean and I are 25 and he's 26. His birthday is coming up January. We have been on and off since high school. I have been with other guys and still we have remained friends. Ever since I graduated, I'm living a real adult life. Okay. I work two jobs, engineer during the day and restaurant manager at night. Okay. Here and there, we would hang out as friends and eventually we made a mutual understanding that we should give a real relationship a try. We already knew each other's friends and family, and so I thought, he is a homeboy, and so I thought he would be faithful. I could already see where this is gonna go. Recently, he randomly mentioned he had a girl best friend. Oh, God, I already been there, done that. Okay. I knew him, but if she was really important to him, I said I wanted to meet her. We tried to set up and move to a party where she could come, and he said she couldn't make it. They could never make it. I had more occasions and invited her, but she always had an excuse. I was irritated at this point and just said, I don't feel comfortable hitting you up if I can't meet her. Mind you, he met all of my guy friends, and this one, he makes me feel a bit insecure. So he said he'd stop talking to her. Then days later, she's blowing up his phone while I'm with him, while he's with me, and she was acting weird and hung up. So my gut feeling said, go through his phone because something's up. I go through his phone and he's reaching out to people on Black, Twitter, and more, exchanging pics and flirting. I threw him out of my house pissed. Months go by of course not speaking. He apologized and it's closer to his birthday and he wanted to hang out around Christmas. He said he has changed, got a new job, hasn't been on any apps or anything like that. The question I have for you is, I'm not sure if he's changed. How will I know? Okay, so first of all, right, let me just tell you this right now, right? I've been through the whole female best friend random bullshit, right? Literally, the last time I had a nigga that had a female best friend that I know about, he literally left me to go be with her, and now they're married with a kid, and he's going through a divorce. But anyhow, this is not about me, this is about you. So, with that being said, why would you even want to give a nigga like that a chance? A nigga practically cheated on you. You probably didn't really catch him cheating, but, like, you kind of caught him cheating. So what do you want to go waste your time with that for? I feel like a lot of this, trust me, I've been there, done that. A lot of these questions, right, that a lot of you guys be asking, a lot of it has to come from a place of lack of self-respect and self-love, right? It has to. Because when somebody does some shit like this to you, you would assume, I'm not going back. Now, one thing, even when I was a dumb bitch once with that person. I wasn't a dumb bitch continuously, like, with the exception of, like, maybe one or two people. Like, you know, after that, I learned my lesson for real. But, like, usually when a nigga would cheat on me, I would never date them again or fuck them again. Because, like, you cheated. I don't know what STD you had. I don't know what fleas or cooties you might have after that. So I don't understand. What are you asking? How do you know if he's changed? Why does it matter? Is there not plenty of dick in the sea? Was that what they say? Oh no, fish, my bad. Dick, fish, same shit. Is there not plenty of people? This is very, like, he's already dropped. He's already down. He's gone. Why are you trying to pick him back up? Do you have nothing to do? Is there no other men in your life? Is there no other option? Is his dick that good that you have to stoop down to go pick his ass up again? For what? Like, I really want to know. I really, really want to know, like, what is the actual point of sitting here trying to get back with a nigga that you know was out here talking, dating, fucking, we don't even know, to be honest, what other females. Chances are, if you had a female best friend and he didn't want you to meet her, she's ghosting you, you picking up the phone, she hanging up all this goofy shit, they have something going on. That's one. You see him sending pictures to bitches on different sites and all of that extra shit. And y'all big as hell. This at y'all big age. With y'all 25, 26, at y'all big age. Come on. Come on. And you talk about something's been a couple months. Change where? The only thing that nigga probably changed was his drawers. Barely. Barely. He probably didn't even wash his ass. Like, come on now. Like, at his big age. Is this not something he should know not to do? Like, come on. This is ridiculous. You already know that this should be something that this should be something that is self-explanatory. You should already know that you should not be doing this to yourself. He ain't shit. He proved that he wasn't shit. Move on, move along. Go find another dick in the sea. There's plenty of dick in the sea. Like, it's not that damn hard. And I saw someone said, what's moving my curtain? My cat, most likely. Yeah, well, she's sleeping now, but she be down there. Like, it's ridiculous. It's really annoying how people really be trying to ask the most. It's weird. It's very weird. Like, you already know the answer to that question. Leave that man alone. Leave that man alone. At your big age. At your big age. That nigga probably ain't even wash his ass. And you wanna... I'm sorry. I just can't. My thing is, when these niggas be cheating, they be mad dirty. They be mad solid. They want to go stick their dick in you after they literally just let another girl suck them off. Therefore, I'm not... No. No. So if you already know that a nigga's been treating you garbage, don't even waste your time, bro. Don't even waste your time. That nigga about to bring you hella STDs, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, X, Y, Z. Okay? And everything in between. Why subject yourself to this mess, bro? This is why everybody got an STD. Okay, not everybody has a STD. But so many people got STDs these days. Because everybody just fuck with everybody and nobody's using their, like, senses. Like, if you know a nigga's cheating on you, especially don't go back and fuck with the nigga. Because you don't know what he about to bring back to you, bro. Like, no. This is not okay. Like, this is not okay at all. Like, at all. Like, you are not even a kid, bro. Like, you my age. No. Do you know how many people are, like, no. No. I've had friends that have tried to tell me this bullshit, like, shit like this. Like, yeah, what should I do? And I just be like, you know damn well you got the wrong number. Don't ever come to me about bullshit like this. Because you already know I'm going to tell you to leave. And then you're not going to leave. And then I'm going to get upset. So just don't tell me. Like, I'm the type of friend that you can't tell me this type of shit. And I know a lot of people are like, well, you're supposed to be a friend. Well, I don't let my friends do stupid shit in my presence. I'm not that type of friend. I'm not going to sit there and tell my friends that it's okay to be dumb. I'm not going to sit there and tell my friends it's okay to subject themselves to bullshit because they like someone, because they love someone, because they have a kid with someone, because they're married. I don't give a fuck. Someone treats you like garbage, you leave. You take the trash out. Someone's cheating on you. They don't care about your health. They don't care about your well-being. They don't care about your mental health. They don't care about you whatsoever. So why would you sit there and put them on a pedestal and keep allowing them to do that? I don't care who you are. I don't understand. Like, you're saying you're living this adult life, but like, oh, child, something just flew in my eye. You living this adult life, but how adult is it? I don't know. This the adult life? I'm doing it wrong because I don't get it. Like, I'm dead serious. Like, I really, this is literally how I operate, y'all. Like, I kid you not, like, there's literally friends that I have where I tell them, do not tell me anything about this person anymore because I'm done talking about this. I'm done talking about this person. I'm done talking about the situation. I'm done talking about this man, woman, dog, cat, horse. I don't want to hear it because at this point, I already said what I said and I don't say anything more than twice. So at that point, you're stupid and you put yourself there. Like, I'm not about to keep coming back. Like, why does some of y'all need someone to keep telling you something over and over again? I'm not your fucking parent. And even if I did have a kid and I did have to keep telling them that, that's probably the only one I would probably do. Maybe if I have kids, I'll probably be like, I might drill it into their head because, you know, that's my kid. I kind of brought them here, sadly, you know. No one wants to be here. I say this shit all the time. Why the fuck my parents bring me here? Now I got to pay bills. Now I got to deal with stupid shit. I got to deal with dumbass people. So, you know what? If I ever bring kids into this world, I'm going to be like, you know what? I literally brought you here and I'm so fucking sorry. So I'm literally going to help you the best way I can because at this point, I owe it to you because I brought you here to pay bills and deal with more stupid people. So... other than that, I'm not your goddamn parent. So don't be sitting here and making me doing all this stupid shit. I'm not going to do this. I'm not. common sense should be a lot more common. Like, if you're... y'all, I just can't. It's really sad. It's really sad. Like, I really thought about really going back to school for psychology so I could really charge niggas. Like, can I charge your insurance? Like, I really wanted to, like, start charging my friends. Like, can I please charge your insurance? Can I please? Because that'd be great. Because, like, I'll be spending 3-4 hours trying to tell you that you're stupid and you don't listen. it don't make sense. So, I mean, to be honest... it is what it is at this point. Girl, get your life. I will be looking at a little bit more comments that we're going to get off in about 10 to 15. Ooh, this tastes good. Do what? He like that, Shawty, I need tips to every day I want to jump out of our window. Wait, what? What are y'all talking about? There are times when ghosting is essential. No, dead ass, bro. No, that ghosting shit. I mean, it depends. Some people, when it comes to ghosting, it depends, right? I used to do that all the time. I would ghost people all the time. Honestly, ghosting worked very well for me. The only problem I had with ghosting is, like, eventually when a person saw me, I'd have to answer. Or, like, eventually, like, I would forget why I don't like the person. And then, like, you know, we end up being cool again. And I'm like, yeah, this is why I don't like your dumb ass. But ghosting worked for me. And I see a lot of people asking about, someone asked if I'm engaged. If you guys are not aware, when you're engaged, you put that on the left hand. This is my left hand. This is my right. So no, I'm not engaged. I am in a very serious relationship though. And, someone's asking, I see a lot of people talking about strict parents, how to deal with strict parents. If you're over 18, you get the fuck out. That's it. Like, that's how you deal with them. Wait, what? Wait, what is going on my phone? Oh my God, it's too much. Y'all, this is why I don't look at my phone while I'm going live. Because the shit that be on my phone sometimes, I'll just be sitting there like, why are y'all saying this? Why are y'all bothering me with this nonsense right now? Like the gibberish, the nonsense. Anyhow. So strict parents, right? Strict parents, honestly, if you're over the age of 18, get out. You should have been stacking your money to get the fuck out. Whether you're going to literally go out through school, you're going to go out through buying your way out in terms of like legit, you know, getting a job, saving up and moving out, or you're going to go live in a shelter. Listen, I have family that's done it. They lived in a shelter, then stacked up to get their own apartment. I'm telling you this right now. Just leave. Just leave. Just leave. If you can. Now, for younger people, the best advice I could give for people that can't leave their house yet is honestly just stay out of your parents' way. Like, I feel like for a lot of kids, I don't know what's up with y'all, right? Like, I understand parents ain't shit sometimes, right? Some parents be doing way too much. Some parents be doing, like, this whole power trip situation. I feel like a lot of parents have this situation where it's like they feel like they could just boss their kids around. They could be mean to their parents. They can be rude to their parents. They can be, and hold up. For the people, let me just answer this Troyce thing. Troyce did not live with me. Oh, did alive. Troyce did alive with me recently. Troyce is fine, but if you want to go know how Troyce is, why don't you go DM Troyce? I don't understand why you're asking me how Troyce is. Please just go hit up Troyce. Yeah, stop spamming. It's very annoying because that's not what we're talking about. It's very, like, unnecessary. Yeah, when it comes to the choice, I said choice, wow. When it comes to the whole strict parent situation, I feel like strict parents are annoying and all, but like for some kids, sometimes like I see a lot of kids hit me up and they're like, oh, my mom wants me to do this. My dad doesn't like me doing that. And it's like, what's so hard about just doing what your parents say, right? If it's toxic, for real, I get it. Like if it's like, you know, your parents are beating the shit out of you. Your parents are making you do something sexual. Your parents are forcing you to, I don't know, just do something illegal. Like, I feel like when your parents are putting you into something like legit extreme duress, it's an issue. But some of y'all really be sending me emails like, oh, my mom got mad at me because I had bad grades and now she won't let me go outside. They're so strict. And I'm just like, don't fucking go outside. Like, I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Like, if your parents aren't starving you, thank you, Afro-Marky. If they're not starving you, if they're literally not, like, beating the shit out of you every 2 seconds and stuff like that, I really don't think it's that serious. I feel like there's a difference between strict parents and parents you don't like. I feel like a lot of y'all just don't like y'all parents. That's just that. For the most part, if your parents are telling you to do something, just fucking do it. Just stay out of their way and do it. They tell you to clean the house, clean the house. They tell you to go to sleep at a certain time, go to sleep at a certain time. They're telling you to go to school, go to school. They're telling you to wash the dishes, wash the dishes. They're telling you to do the laundry, do the laundry. They're telling you to go to your aunt's house, go to your aunt. It's not that fucking hard. But for whatever reason, y'all kids be watching too much goddamn Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. I don't know. Too much Disney. I don't know what y'all watching. Where y'all think y'all could just be sassy, talk back, and do all of this dumb shit. And then all of a sudden, it's a problem. Now y'all causing more problems than it needs to be. And it's an issue. Now for the people that have legitimately narcissistic, horrible, abusive, parents, that's a whole nother issue. Now, for those people, the only thing you can really do is, one, you could report your parents, but then you face the whole issue of you're going to end up in the whole system. That's the problem there. You're going to be forced into the system. You're going to be forced into, you know, foster homes and homelessness. Thank you. How to deal with narcissist mom who follows you around in life, 25 years old. Stormy, you a whole fucking adult. Stop playing with me. Mm-mm. Narcissistic parents, you 25, just move. Come on, y'all. Just move. You 25, you can definitely move. Move out of state. Y'all, there's something in my eye. I think it's these lashes I just got done. This shit stressing me out. But essentially, when it comes to narcissistic parents, when it comes to all of those types of parents, the most you can do is get away from them as much as you can, as fast as you can. I'm not trying to advise y'all to get like into the foster care system or anything like that, because it can really get bad. It can really get bad. You do not want to get like that, because it gets really, really bad. Because we all have heard of the horrible stories. Now, in terms of after that, of course, you have emancipation, but it's very hard to get emancipated as a minor. You have to prove that you are able to financially support yourself at a very young age. You have to prove that you will have somewhere to live. All of that extra shit, very hard. Very hard to get out of, you know, your parents' house. And it's very hard to prove to a judge or a court that you'll be able. Ooh, child. Child. I can't. This is too much. Something in my eye. You have to be able to prove that you'll be able to take care of yourself by yourself without any adult help. That's basically what it is. So those are your two main options, emancipation or literally just going to report your own parents, but you face foster problems. Or you could just go to, I would say, I feel like that's still foster problems. If you do have a school counselor or whatever, you could always just talk to them. Seek services of therapy, whatever, from them, because usually they'll help you. Usually they'll sit there and they'll give you some sort of psychiatric services, but sometimes, for the most part, they'll have to report it if it's anything that's that bad. If they're like really, you know, beating the shit out of you or psychologically abusing you, that's gonna be bad. So those are literally your only three options. And I saw you answered, hey Yanni, how are you, girl? I see that a lot. Okay, you said, Stormy, you said that you keep moving, but she keeps bothering you. She keeps following you. First of all, I don't know where you're moving to, but you're going to have to move to, like, the other side of the world and, like, not tell your parents where you're going. Like, you're going to have to be like, listen, I'm moving to, well, you can't tell them, right? How are they finding out where you're living? Yeah, because that's weird. Your parent sounds very scary. Like, that sounds very scary, because I've never heard anything like that. Thanks, Yanni. I've never heard anything like that in my entire life. Like, what kind of parent sits there and stalks their child like that? And how the fuck are they finding out? Maybe she has a tracking on you. She might have a tracking device on your phone or on your car. You might literally need a whole new phone and a whole new car. You might need to change your name if it's really that serious. And get a restraining order and move without telling her anything. If you have social media, change them, delete them, whatever. Don't update your shit. Because that's mad scary. I've never heard anything like that. You said family. Why are you telling your family? Stop telling your family where you're going. Don't tell them shit. Listen, move and don't tell no one nothing. Move out of state and don't tell them shit. Mm-mm. And then press harassment charges. Thank you. Yup. Gypsy Rose, you damn right.
I want to move but can't afford it on my own. Oh, shit. I can't see. I'm sorry. The idea of roommate is low-key scary. To be quite honest with you, yeah, I almost had a roommate, but I would never do that again. Never, 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 never. I did it in college. It actually wasn't that bad, but I would never go into that idea of doing it as an adult.
honestly, just stack up, and probably you might just have to move to a state that's way cheaper, or just keep looking for, you know, cheap places. I don't know where you live, but if you do live in, like, better yet, go on Facebook and try to find gypsy housing. You could just rent a room, or you could just rent a studio, or you could just rent a small one bedroom, because usually those are cheaper, depending on where you live, because there's a lot of places, like, especially in Jersey, it's very expensive. Jersey, New York, very expensive, but places like Pennsylvania, even, like, just down south are 10 times cheaper, so. And those places are a lot cheaper. Like, usually you can afford to live in those places for a lot less money. So if you just, like, spend your time on gypsy housing. Gypsy housing usually has a lot of stuff for different states, but usually gypsy housing is good for New York. But yeah, my roommates were good, except for junior year. It was a hot ass mess, but other than that, I was fine. And yeah, the live is not going to be deleted. Any advice on dating during a pandemic? Me and my boyfriend have had legitimately a fucking COVID relationship, but I knew him before. So, I mean, I don't know if there's any, I don't know how to explain it. How do I explain it? Like, I don't know what advice I can give. Like, me and my boyfriend been together since a little bit before the pandemic, and we knew each other before the pandemic, so I don't know what advice I can really give. I don't know. Let's see. Let's see. If a boy likes you and you like him and claims you as their wifey, does he really want to be with him? If he didn't ask you to be his official girlfriend, don't pay that nigga no mind. Because if a nigga really wants you to be his girlfriend, he's going to tell you legitimately, I want you to be my girlfriend. He's not about to sit there and give you titles and not be your boyfriend. Because he doesn't want anyone else to have you. So all of these play games, these play names and whatever, don't waste your time with it. Trust me. Anyhow. Ooh, child. Shout out to my baby, Smitty, please. I love how real you are. Thank you so much. I'm actually mentally disabled. Oh, Stormy. Okay, so Stormy, that's probably why they're bothering you. They probably think that you're not able to be by yourself. That's what it is, Stormy. They probably think that since you're mentally disabled, you kind of need to be someone. If that makes sense. Like, they probably feel like you need someone to be, you know, watching over you. I've seen stuff like that. So that's probably what it is. So, I don't know how that's going to work. I don't know if you'll be able to even get them to stop bothering you. Like, now that I think about it, I don't know how you would get away from that. Okay, let's see. Oh, child, there's a lot. Patrick Jenkins. Okay, banning. Ooh. Hold up. Okay, I banned Patrick Jenkins. There you go. Sorry, y'all. I didn't even see that until now. I had to scroll all the way up. All right. Wait, what? How do I tell my strict mom that I have a boyfriend? Why are they doing all that goofy shit? I don't want to say don't. It depends on how old you are. Let me tell you how old you are. Tell me how old you are, then I'll tell you. That's the best way. Congratulations, Divine. I'm getting off of here in 2 minutes. Oh, thank you guys. You guys are so nice. You're 18? No, you're not the one that answered the question. I mean, that asked the question. I'm 14. No, don't tell her shit. No. Girl, just relax. It's probably not even gonna be that serious. I'm gonna tell you this right now. For everyone in a relationship that's under the age of 23, I would say. It's probably not even that serious. I'm telling you this right now. Don't even waste your time. Don't even waste your time. Just don't.
Okay, so I have a bunch of skincare routines in my description. So if you guys are wondering, a lot of the stuff that you guys be asking me every 2 seconds are in my description box. So literally just go there. Like, it's so much easier just go in the description box. Like, a lot of shit just be there. Let's see. How to motivate yourself during school and COVID. Honestly, I did not go through school and COVID, so I cannot tell y'all anything about that. My sister's having a baby and is living in our house. What sleep tips do you have? I don't know. That sounds really sad. You better get some earplugs. Why do parents think once they turn 18, they stop doing their job as a parent? Because technically, y'all an adult. And y'all love to be like, oh, I'm 18, I'm an adult. So you go to pick one. You better be a kid or you want to be an adult. I mean, it depends. It depends on what type of kid you are. Because a lot of kids, as soon as they turn 18, they want to act like they're grown. So it all depends. It all depends. Facts, people who complain and whine about bad lovers and refuse to leave or take advice, you must, yeah. How do I work on being assertive at work and telling my Haitian mom that her man isn't good for her? Mind your business. When it comes to people like that, like when it comes to your parents, let me tell you this right now. If you guys have parents and they're in a relationship and you don't like them being in that relationship, mind your business, because they're not going to listen to you. They're not going to listen to shit you say. They're going to think that you a hater. They're going to think that you're trash. And unless they see whatever it is that you're trying to see or say themselves, they're not going to believe you. They're going to think that you're just a malicious piece of shit and you are hindering them for all happiness. So just mind your business. Literally mind your business, because they're not going to listen to you. That's not your place. Oh, well, unless the man is like literally raping someone or killing people, that's the only thing that matters. If not, then oh, well, or beating the shit out of her. Other than that, mind your business. She's not going to listen to you. She's not going to listen. It's no point. It's like, shit like that just be a waste. A whole waste. Wow, I'm really trying to scroll through. Okay. I'm going to answer one really good question. Wait, what? Okay. Hold up, what? Me and my husband are expecting. I've been away from home for years and my mother is involved in drug and gang activities. I need advice. What advice do you need? Stay away from home. Stay away from your family. What the fuck? No. Don't ever bring your kid around that shit. What kind of shit? Oh, God. Yeah, stay away from your mom and any other family that is involved in that shit. That's the most advice I could give you. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. That is ridiculous. Okay. That is ridiculous. Ooh. Okay, I'm going to answer one more and then I'm out of here. Ooh, there's so much. Whew. Thank you guys so much for being here. Wow, there was a good amount of y'all here today. Goddamn. Y'all showed up for the Mafia. Ooh, y'all showed up for the Mafia Speaks today. Oh my God, I'm literally just scrolling through some of these. I missed so many of these comments. Oh, all right. Thank you, Felicia. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Love your YouTube channel. Thank you, Pinky. I'm sorry if I missed anybody else's super chats. It's very hard for me to like speak and look at the screen and look at myself and make sure I'm in focus, because sometimes this camera be playing games with me. I swear to God. Like, it's very difficult. It's very, very difficult. Oh my God.
All right, this is my last question. How do I deal with a mother who is never sober and constantly hits and degrades me? You call the cops? I'm going to hell. I'm sorry. Hold up. It depends. How old are you? Because I don't want you to go into the foster care system. That's not fun. That's not... Oh, my God. There's so much going on. There's so much going on. I hope this girl answers. I'm trying to see how old you are, because if you're young, I don't think that's a good idea. I mean, to be honest, I don't know. Like, homegirls, honestly, I don't think there's anything else. The only thing I could honor, yeah, like you said, another relative, Panda Lover, you're right. The only way, twin sister, okay. If you have another relative you can live with, that would be 10 times better, because this is not okay. Next thing you know, she kills you, she kills yourself, herself. That is not an okay situation. You're going to either need to call authorities or go find someone else to live with, because she needs to get help and get clean. That's not okay. Why do you guys have, like, the same name? Okay, anyways. Yeah, call the cops. None of them got time for this. Like, no. This is no. You guys... And don't feel bad about it. She needs help. And sadly, with a lot of these people, they only know help when authorities are involved. They only know help when they're thrown in jail. They only know help when authorities are forced to force authority upon them. That's when they only know help. So to be quite honest with you, don't even feel bad if somehow, some way you have to call the fucking jail on them. Wait, did I miss the story? Hi, Stormy. Lemon character offering a gift to baby Lemon. Oh, thank you, Stormy. So, yeah, I am done here. I really hope you guys get help. Oh, she's in the military. Isn't there already help for them? Yeah, I really hope you guys get help, because, wait, she's calling the cops on herself? Yeah, that's a hard one. I don't get it. Honestly, I'm gonna have to get off of here, though, because I have to go pick someone up. But I am, oh, wow, Sage is, like, dead over there. Like, she is not. But, yeah, thank you guys so much for being here. Oh, excuse me. The Haitian Dominican Live should be next Friday. I hope everyone does well, sleeps well, all of your issues are resolved. Call authorities on whoever needs to be called. For real, make sure you guys always do what's best, always do what's right. For those of you guys who are watching this post live, thank you guys so much for sitting through an hour and almost 30 minutes of this shit. And also, please make sure you comment down below advice for everyone else, okay? Comment down advice, because people needs the shits. They need the advice, okay? Because sometimes my advice is not enough, and sometimes there's some things that I just don't read into that a lot of you guys can definitely, relate to and give advice about. So thank you guys so very much. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for being part of this, you know, sector of the internet. And like, share, subscribe, do all that. Next upload will be on Monday. And I'ma see y'all next time.